Hello everybody, this is our science video for today, Monday, May 4th. We're going to be talking about fossils for the next couple of weeks. For those of you who missed our Zoom session, we started talking about fossils and how they're made. So I gave you the unit page, fossils, and a couple of other pages. After that, it's the essential questions. Okay, just so you see what lessons that are coming up that we're going to be learning about. The big idea here in this unit is how do fossils help us understand Earth's history? And that's, again, on the unit page right here, okay? The reading starts on page 455, okay? So I'm going to read that to you right now. It's called Traces of the Past, okay? Looks like this. You could find seashells on many ocean beaches. These shells are from animals that are living today. Suppose you found a rock that had something in it that looks like a seashell. This is a trace of an animal that lived long ago. What other traces of past life might you find? So we talked about how animals are preserved, okay? One way is they're frozen, okay? So this is an ancient mammoth. A real mammoth that's frozen, okay? This is very rare. Usually it's just the bones that are preserved. But because it was frozen so perfectly, the tissues and organs are preserved. Here's a picture of a mosquito in an amber, okay? Amber is when this tree sap hardens, okay? And it's hardened over millions of years. So the mosquito or other types of insects get trapped in the tree sap, that sticky stuff that comes off the trees. And that can preserve them. Another way is the carbon footprint. So that's a footprint of a plant, okay? Almost as if you took a piece of paper, those tracing papers, and you rubbed a pencil over it. And then what you get is like that traced version of the image. That's what this is, okay? Then there's also sometimes, believe it or not, footprints. Get left behind, okay? If they're walking in mud and the mud hardens. So that's another way. Animals and plants are fossilized. But the most common way that you guys probably know about is bones, okay? Because bones are they're a lot stronger than soft tissues. So we're going to go ahead and go to page 455, okay? And 455 talks about how fossils are formed, okay? So it says the preserved remains or traces of a living thing is called a fossil. Fossils can be made of an organism's hard parts or its soft parts. Hard parts include bones, teeth, and shells. Soft parts are tissues such as skin and organs. Because bacteria quickly breaks down soft tissue, soft parts are rare as fossils. Okay, that's what I said. It's very rare that you find a perfectly preserved animal with its tissue and its organs. Soft part fossils can be original tissue if it's been frozen or dried out as like in a mummy. Okay, how Egyptians buried their dead. They can also be preserved as an impression in a rock. Most fossils are found in sedimentary rock, which means it's settled. It's rock that's settled, exactly how the word sounds, sedimentary. It's settled to the bottom, okay? If you look, it says one common way that fossils form is shown at the right. And if you look at the right where it says fossil formation, you see all this rock that has sank down to the bottom of the ocean. So you have a dead fish that's kind of sinking to the bottom of the ocean. It gets trapped in this sedimentary rock, and then it gets fossilized, and then it's the people's job to dig it up, okay? Archaeologists and paleontologists dig up bones and fossils and study them. Another way is, this is a little bit more complicated, but minerals such as quartz replace the shell or plant material that made up the organism, and that's how petrified wood forms. Sometimes the replacement is so perfect that even the bark of wood grain are visible. This is a mold or cast of plants. Okay? So this is similar to as if you put a ceramic cast around your face. Okay? A lot of actors have to do this to make masks, okay, for a movie. It's a liquid, and then it hardens, and it makes a cast mold of your face, and it's the same exact shape of your face. Well, this is the same concept, okay, except it's with plants, okay? It says, these mold and cast fossils were made when a leaf was pressed into soft mud, leaving a hollow space called a mold. And then a cast can form if the mold is later filled with mud that hardens. So like I said, the same concept. This leaf is pressed against the mud, okay? And it makes an impression in the mud, almost similar as footprints would make an impression in the mud. Once the mud hardens, then it makes this cast. And it looks like an exact replica of the actual leaf. Okay, so this little white box here is the question that you have to complete for today, okay? It says, what might you leave behind? I want you to think about this before you do it. It says, draw a set of footprints or other trace that you might leave. Explain what part of your body would make the trace and what trace your fossil would tell future scientists. So take a separate piece of paper. If you have a blank piece of paper, maybe you want to trace your feet or your hands. Just an idea, but any body part that you want to have fossilized, okay? And then explain, what would this tell future scientists about you or about humans today, okay? So that's that question, okay? Second part of today's lesson, I'm going to post in another video, okay? It's going to be about fossils that burn, okay? We're going to talk about carbon and coal, and then how eventually that from coal, we could produce refined gasoline and oil that we use for many applications, planes, cars, you name it, okay? This is the first part of the lesson for today, okay? So your assignment is to decide what kind of footprint you want to leave behind, okay? And what is it going to tell future scientists about us, okay? All right, thanks for watching and stay tuned for part two. Thanks.